So this formula, how has it been applied? So it's been applied to what's sometimes called a graph. A graph. Have you ever seen? So we've looked at this formula. We've looked at this formula for the Euler characteristic of a surface. We constructed a surface using a gluing diagram, and we proved the Euler characteristic was an invariant of gluing diagram. And for example, if the surface was a sphere, then the Euler characteristic was 2. But we haven't proved the formula for graphs. So let me say what a graph is. So a graph.
Он спрашивает, почему формула верна?
Мы можем уничтожать
одну. Не уничтожать.
Склеивать.
Нет, лучше сказать так, что мы можем разрезать по ребрам и получить диаграмму склейки. Если пропилить вот по этим ребрам, представить себе, что ребра это такие рамки.
In this context, we're applying to what's called a graph. So a graph is, so here are some graphs, and I'll find this in just a moment. So when we play our game of Brussels sprouts, have you seen these kind of diagrams before? Graphs. This is a graph. This is a vertices, and these are edges. So a graph is split into vertices. Connected by edges. So you have seen, okay. And a graph is planar if no two edges cross. So this would not be a planar graph. Let me. No two edges cross and a non vertex. And a graph is connected if any two vertices are connected by a sequence of edges. So let me just draw some examples in here. So here's one graph. Is it connected?
Yeah.
Is it planar?
Yes.
Okay. Is this graph planar?
Yes.
Is it connected?
Yes.
So this guy isn't connected because I can't get to this. I can't connect these two vertices along edges. Okay. And is this graph connected?
Yes.
Is it planar?
Yes.
Because we can.
No, it's not
planar.
Why?
Он не планарный, но его можно изобразить.
Скажите.
We can draw the same graph, but without.
Okay, so here I should say, okay, so this is the same as. So if it can be drawn, it's plane. If it can be drawn in a plane so that no two edges cross. So I should say it was planar if it can be drawn. Very good. And okay, so now, if we have such a graph, so here is this, where this number comes up. If a graph is connected, then it's planar. So if it's connected and planar, then
V minus U plus F is true.
Then this formula applies. So for example, in this example, what does this come out to be? How many vertices?
In what example?
Oh, so this one here.
Three.
Oh, how many edges?
One.
Is it one? It isn't connected.
How many edges?
One.
So the idea is this formula should
one.
Be. Oh, so it does come out. Okay, well, that's not a good example. So. What about if I give another vertex?
It is still not connected.
Yes, but what I'm asking you, what does this number come out to be?
4 minus 1 plus
1.
It's
4. 4? Oh, okay, so I forgot the other. 4 minus 1 plus 1 is 4. So what I'm pointing out is this formula only applies if it's connected in planar. Okay. And what if it's not connected and it's still planar? So before we prove that, I'd like one of you to prove that for us, but so you know if there are more let me say so. If a graph is planar and is I'll write the word and then I'll ask you to and then I'll explain it. K connected components. Then V minus E plus F
K plus 1.
So now when we say connect the components, that means to count them up, you put your... How many connected components does this graph have?
Three.
Okay, so connected components, a component is just a subgraph. You start with one vertex and you go as... wherever you can, but this part of the graph is not connected to this part of the graph, and this is not connected to this part of the graph, so the three. So this is what we mean by connected components, and Maxine gave us this formula. So would you like to prove it for us?
Максим, по индукции докажите там, ну ребра отрезать и так далее. Доказать эту формулу для любого графа на плоскости.
And the reason is there's one little bit.
По индукции.
Every two. Connected components.
Would you like to?
We can.
Не надо. Надо по индукции просто брать ребро и отрезать. Сначала, если есть просто висячая вершина, ее убираем. Говорим, что все, ну, что все хорошо. Если есть ребро, смотрим, как оно может быть там. Компонент увеличивается количество.
Сначала на цикл надо смотреть.
Ну именно, что берете ребро, смотрите, входит оно в цикл, не входит оно в цикл, и разрезаете. Все, давайте поехали. Возьмем вершину. Если у нее нет ребер.
Хорошо.
Вперед.
Что?
Рассмотрим любую вершину.
Let us consider we have a planar graph and it has k connected components. So we can.
На следующий случай база индукции нужна. База индукции, когда просто нет ребер. Когда есть на плоскости k точек.
We will
base of induction.
We need to prove the base of induction.
In mass, what are you inducting on? The number of
the sum of
количество ребер и вершин. Пока сумма количества. Значит, сумма количества ребер и вершин.
Sum of vertices and inches.
And the base is when there are no vertices and no edges, it is true.
T is equal to 0.
It is it's 0, 0, it's 1, it's 0.
Mm-hmm.
If a cycle.
Нет, сначала вершину одну отбросить. Если в графе есть одна вершина без ребер.
If we have one vertex in the graph, we can just erase it, and then the number of components will. Will be less by one, and the number of vertices will be less by one.
So, a free vertex, so some vertex is disconnected from it. Mm-hmm.
So, in our graph, there are no lonely vertices.
Mm-hmm.
So,
cycle.
Cycle.
Если есть цикл.
If a cycle is
последовательность. a sequence.
The sequence of edges connected together like a cycle. So in the cycle, if we erase one edge, the number of
sequence, последовательность.
The number of edges would be less by one, and the number of faces will be less by one. So the sum is not.
So the e goes down to by one. So this minus becomes a.
So it is plus one, mm-hmm. and this is minus one. So because this was something else, mm-hmm. there were two faces, and now there is one face.
Максим, уменьшится это decrease.
So at last, our graph would became a tree, a graph without a tree or several trees.
Force,
yes, because the graph without cycles is a tree.
Mm-hmm.
So okay. So trees. I should prove one theorem.
Ну вот именно отрезайте висячую любовь.
In every tree exists a list, a leaf. Okay, let us take the vertices in the tree. Go from these vertices in.
Нет, если надо взять не vertices, а какую-нибудь одну.
One vertex and go in one direction. If it is a leaf, everything is good. Leaf, it is vertex with one edge, connected by one edge.
That's.
So let's go from vertices in from vertex into another vertex, and from another vertex into another vertex. Not this one. Because if we can't go anywhere, it is a leaf.
Надо сказать, что не возвращаемся.
Я сказал.
Не возвращаемся, важно. Все время движемся в одну сторону.
We can't go back to the, to the previous page. And because there are no cycles, we would stop into the leaf.
Когда-нибудь остановимся, да?
We would stop in the leaf.
И найдем таким образом лист.
And we found a leaf in the graph. So let us erase in the graph the
вершину и ребро
единственное in the graph erase so the number of vertices would decrease by one and number of edges would increase by one. The formula would be true. And this is also true. So at last we would get vertices, k vertices.
Вы уже сказали, что по одной вершине.
For one vertices we have already proved the base.
Mm-hmm.